is sprinting along the hot desert highway and is miles away from the nearest town.
Officers have been in pursuit now for well over half an hour.
Police are baffled as to why this suspect is running. He's only wanted for a minor traffic violation. But there are five people in the car.
If you look closely, you can see that it's a packed car down there.
And whether or not the passengers like it, they're all along for the ride. The suspect deliberately swerves into the path of gaining cruisers.
He is all over the road. Looks like he's doing everything he can to keep police from passing.
With nothing ahead but open highway, the driver thinks he has the edge on police. But the officers are on the lookout for their own golden opportunity.
Well, we're 20 miles in the desert now, and there really isn't a heck of a lot of traffic.
The suspect has a guardrail to the left and a solid wall of rock to the right. It's the perfect place for a barricade.
There are several units that have blocking that lane, and he falls. He gets awfully close to that cruiser.
Two officers scramble for cover as the outlaw takes aim and shoots past the stop sticks. The success of his slick move makes this fugitive feel invincible. But police are intent on stopping this guy using every available means.
Police have been given the go-ahead to stop this suspect by force.
Sergeant Dennis Isaacson overtakes the suspect. With a full car, the suspect can't accelerate fast enough, and Isaacson pulls in front of him.
The patrol car is positioning himself just in front of the Buick.
Just as the fugitive tries to pass, the sergeant turns his cruiser into a rolling wedge of steel.
Wow, there you can see this officer pulling up a very difficult move at these speeds.
The machine finally grinds to a halt. Moments later, the driver and his passengers are laid out on the same scorching blacktop.
Looks like it's all over.
That was supposed to be their ticket out of town. This dude thought he had it all figured out.
Officers have been in the pursuit now for well over half an hour.
The police were the ones with the real advantage.
There really isn't a heck of a lot of traffic.
Because this driver wasn't exactly an experienced crook, but only a teenage kid. He stole the car and used it as a lethal weapon.